Raj Bisram runs a 1,000-item auction every month. He's not just seen it all, he's bought and sold it all too.
I'm going to make you an offer. This is such an unusual item. It's right up my street, sporting item. This has got me really excited. Sophie, that's the nature of this game. Sometimes you have to take a gamble. And sometimes, maybe your first offer can be your best. At the right price, this would be definitely easy to sell. People often ask me what motivates me. And it's not the money, it's the thrill of the deal.
Whilst his partner in crime this week is newcomer to the road trip, expert auctioneer Raj Bisram.
I've just noticed there's a lovely, lovely red serpentine stone lighthouse there. Now, serpentine stone goes back millions of years and it comes in lots of different colours. But the red one, I think, is actually one of the most attractive ones. It's not a cheap piece, but I'm going to speak to Vicky and see what we can do. I'm a little bit out of my depth on this, OK? So I'll offer you sort of £15,000. It's only got £14 on the ticket, which isn't a great deal of money. If I can get this for £10, £12, there's got to be a profit in there. I'll go to £18,000.
Here we go. We park up here.
And it's got a really nice little finish to it. And it's nice detail, too, as well, on that. Very few are in good condition that are still left. And at auction, they should make between £40 and £60, yeah? I mean, they're late 19th century, early 20th century ones. I'll go to £7,500. I'll go to £9,000. I'll go to £9,900. It's just that if I pay over 10, I'm just going to be very unhappy. This is really, really quite nice. It's a copper inkwell, but it's slightly different because it's very Art Nouveau-y, and it looks like it might be from the Newlyn School, which is obviously not very far from here, because the Newlyn School started around the 1880s and went on till the early 20th century, and it's where a lot of artists went from the cities down here, because they became a colony, basically, and they were all able to help each other and work on art forms. And this looks very, very typically of a Newlyn Art Nouveau-y piece. I can't see a signature on this at all, but it would have sat on a desk. It's missing its liner, which it would have had, but it's definitely got age to it. In fact, it's got here possibly Newlyn, and it's got a price on it of £79. For possibly being Newlyn, 79 is quite a heavy ticket. You can buy a well-signed Andy Murray racket for around, you know, £1,500, £1,600 to £2,500.
It's nowhere near what I'm looking to get.
I'll go to £1,000.
I've turned down a lot higher offer than that.
This is my final offer, £1,350.